Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to talk about the ability to use Valgrind and GDB together. I was made aware of this a little less than a year ago from this Red Hat blog posting. Now, this is a feature that has actually existed for a while, but I only just recently learned about it. And it took me some time to get set up to be able to make a proper demonstration for you all. But before I continue, I do want to remind you that I am available for code reviews, on-site training, and that you should check out the links in this video description for more information about this particular topic, sponsors, t-shirts, upcoming events and conferences. Now, the general idea is that Valgrind can act as a remote GDB server using the remote debugging protocol. But you can do that inside of Valgrind and GDB together, basically. You don't actually need a remote computer for this. And it has a bunch of integration with debugging help and the Python support that GDB has for scripting of GDB. All kinds of things, but I am going to focus on just maybe the one little practical thing for why you might want to do this. And then it'll be up to you to decide if it makes sense to actually do this in your work. So I have this very simple example where I am allocating a new int, I am deleting it, and then I am assigning a value in that memory location. And this is very clearly a use after free kind of problem. Now, if I go ahead and compile this without optimizations to make sure that I know that I'm not optimizing out that undefined behavior that many compilers actually will see and execute it, I don't have anything bad happen here, even though it's clearly a use after free. So, if I were to run it through GDB, I can see that I don't actually get anything out here from GDB. It's perfectly fine executing this code with undefined behavior, and it's not giving me any error. If, however, I run it through Valgrind with memcheck, then I get this very obvious use after free. It was memory that was allocated on, well, some line I didn't compile with debug symbols and freed on another location. Let's go ahead and recompile with debug symbols. And now I can see that I had memory allocated on line 3, it was freed on line 4, and it was written to on line 5. Now this is also something that we can rather easily check with address sanitizer. Now, if I try to execute this code, I'm going to get address sanitizer catch it. That is a topic for a different episode, an episode that I've certainly already done at this point. Because the point is about Valgrind. You can't always use address sanitizer and undefined behavior sanitizer in every situation, but Valgrind is often a very good fallback for this kind of thing. Now, I am far from an expert with GDB. So I'm just gonna go ahead and type in the commands that the article tells us to do. I'm gonna launch GDB with that executable. And then I'm also going to set up this remote debugging session. And here I'm telling it to use VGDB. This is the Valgrind GDB server for its remote execution, with remote being in quotes here. You can run Valgrind's GDB server in a completely different process if you want to, but in my experimentation, doing something more like this gave me the better results. Okay, now I'm going to start execution of the program. And yes, download debug info. And I got a breakpoint at the start of this executable. It breaks on the first executed line, which is this new int. We haven't executed that yet, which is kind of handy when we're connecting this remote debugger. And let's go ahead and hit continue. And now I can see inside here that I got a sig trap breakpoint, and it tells me that the block was allocated on line 3, it was freed on line 4, and I wrote to it on line 5. Now, I don't get like great backtrace information or anything here because I don't have a call stack and I don't have anything like reverse debugging set up at the moment. And if you don't know anything about that topic, that is something you should look into. There's a few options available there as well. But anyhow, that is the point. You can integrate Valgrind with GDB and actually get context with a breakpoint for where something goes wrong in your code. And this could be a very powerful debugging tool if you find yourself needing to use these things. So I hope you found this episode of C++ Weekly interesting. This is just one of these little tool spotlights. I've recorded a few of them recently. I hope you enjoy these things. Be sure to leave a comment, and I will catch you in the next episode.